I'm not proud of everything I say. Probably best that I don't have children. She wants to have kids. I'm not ready to mess up children. I'm still just getting used to, you know, being married, being in a relationship, period. I mean, I was single for a long, long time before I met my wife. So it's like, it's a change, you know, like she moved in with me a couple years ago. I felt bad for her. Because, I mean, I lived in my house for like 5 years by myself. I mean, when you're a single guy, it's like, you know, I have a big TV, a soft chair, the fridge works. She moves in. She's like, what's in this room? I'm like, bats. I haven't gone in there in a while. I don't know. Why is there a footprint on the wall? Because I had to show a mosquito who's fucking boss around here rather than a footprint on... She's cleaning and yelling at me for like a week. When was the last time his bathroom was cleaned? I'm like, you'll have to track down the previous owners, all right? Look, I'm tired of all these fucking questions. Because she's from like civilization, you know? I mean, she's from a better class of people, you know? Both her parents were teachers and fucking taxpayers and shit. Like, I mean... I always feel stupid. She'll tell me, like, you know, her parents are going on vacation to Florida or something. I'm like, oh, my dad's burning shit in the backyard right now. That's what he's doing for vacation. You know, she told me growing up in her house, if somebody burped or farted, they had to say, pardon me. That blew my fucking mind. I really, like, my family would be more offended by pardon me. You know, like... Did you just say, pardon me? Oh, guess we're having dinner with the king of fucking England tonight. I had no idea. Somebody's better than us. Look at him. Fucking buttons on his shirt and shit. But yeah, it's an adjustment, though. You know, living with somebody. You gotta learn how to coexist. You know, both ways, really. I mean, you know, because I like warm weather, but inside the house, I'm fat. So, I keep my house like a fucking meat locker all year. I mean, I just, you know, it's 63 no matter when. And she's always cold. And she always says, why do you guys have to keep it so fucking cold in here? I'm like, because it's easier for you to put on a sweatshirt than it is for me to lose 60 fucking pounds. So, I mean... Which one's gonna happen today? I just... you gotta learn how to compromise. You gotta learn how to live together, you know? But it's different. It's a different experience for me altogether, you know? It's like when you're married, you just... I have a woman representing me now. You know, like, she tries to make me look like a decent citizen. You know, like people get, like, birthday cards from me. People know I don't give a shit about them. I mean, people thank me for shit. It's like, you know I didn't send that. I mean, thank you for the fruit basket. Oh, yeah, that was fucking me. Yeah, I know how you like nectarines. That was really... Give a shit. But yeah, well, you know, you do different things. We have different friends. We have couples friends now. That's weird. People you'd never hang out with otherwise, but it's like, oh, but there's two of them. So now they're awesome. Like, we go to a friend's house, a friend has a boyfriend or something. It's like I'm her son. And go play with fucking Jeff. Just throw me together with dudes because we're dudes, you know? Yeah, go talk about your balls or whatever. I mean, it's got to be chemistry. It's got to be the right kind of dude. Like, I don't know if it's a bad quality I have. Like, I can't hang out with dudes who don't know anything about sports. Like, I just think it's weird. I'm like, what do you do? What do you have, dolls and shit? What do you do? Or dudes who like weird sports, you know? I'm mainly into lacrosse. Shut the fuck up, dude. Come on. How are you mainly into lacrosse? What fucking TV package is that that I don't know about? I'm mainly into leaving because I don't like you. But sports, as men, sports gives us something to talk about so we can get to know each other without really having to fucking know each other. You know, because we don't know each other that well. Like, I didn't realize it myself. I never thought about it until I had a wife asking me questions about my friends, and I'm like, I have no fucking answers for you. I mean, you know, my best friend since high school. So what does Tim do for a living? I'm like, he fucking works or some shit. 8 hours a day, I don't fucking see him, I guess. Does he have a girlfriend? I don't know. Is he gay? No. How do you know? I guess I don't. he's never tried to fuck me, but... then again, a lot of people haven't. So that doesn't really determine his sexuality so much as I'm not his type. Either way, I... But it's just, you know, like, but sports are good, you know, barometer to figure out if we're going to be able to, you know, hang out. Like, we're leaving her friend's house. It's like, she set me up on a blind date. It's like, so? What'd you think of Jeff? Like, oh. Well, Jeff thinks LeBron James is better than Michael Jordan, so I think Jeff should fucking die. Does that make me a bad guy? She doesn't think it's that deep, you know? Okay, what about besides that? I'm like, I stopped fucking talking to him after that. I mean, our relationship ended at that point. Did you hear what I said? Because women will talk about more substantial shit, you know? Like, if you're friends, you'll talk about more intimate stuff, you know? Like, you'll talk about your relationship and your sex life, and then she'll tell me, and I don't want to know this shit about people I got to see again. Did you know they only have sex in the kitchen? I fucking do now. Thank you. You didn't know that? No, I just know if we go over there again, we're going to bring our own plates and forks and shit. I mean, because Jeff didn't tell me about the kitchen himself. Now I got to go look Jeff in the eye and act like I don't know about the fucking kitchen. And it's going to get weird. You want something to drink? No, I don't. Jeff, I brought my own cooler of shit in the car. I'm fine. Because if you're ever in a couple's friendship, the women always know more intimate shit about the other couple, and then they put it on us, and we gotta fucking carry it with us. I gotta go to dinner and not giggle. Did you know Jeff likes to put goldfish crackers in his butthole? Why would he ever share that with me? No, that didn't come up. Or are we talking about fantasy fucking football? No, I don't want to know this shit. I'm not enough of a grown-up to have that kind of information at my disposal. Like, I'm not going to use that. Next time me and Jeff are arguing about sports, I'm just going to sit on that fucking gold mine, really? You back me into a corner, I will use what I got to get. I will use whatever I have in my arsenal to survive. Oh, really, Jeff? Peyton Manning has better stats than Tom Brady? Well, I don't think Tom Brady puts fucking crackers up his ass, does he, Jeff? Yeah, you didn't think I knew that shit. Go clean your fucking kitchen and get the fuck away from me, all right? I'm gonna watch lacrosse.